Earn it to own it, and once you got it, you're never ever gonna leave. sweat. And I'm gonna take my smack and you're gonna get another twisted of your sugar to set. My baby got sauce. Your baby ain't sweet like mine.
She got sauce.
Your baby ain't sweet like mine.
She got sauce.
Your baby ain't sweet like mine.
She got sauce.
Nah, she ain't that sweet. But that's some funky lemon that you got going, baby. It's special for me. Did you make it today? Cause I'll always stop by if you like me too. Yeah, I'll do anything that you could ever want for me. So a kiss from someone with a smile and it's done. Yes, I'm your mister, my sister's your sister. My mother's your mother, father's your father. And I started when I kissed her. I missed her, yeah. It was love at first sight. Baby got sauce, and of course, as a matter of course, she does what she wants to, cause oh, she's the boss. Please don't tell my friends about the situation, cause they think I'm on some extended vacation. Cause I don't get out to see my boys anymore. Only time I leave the house is to go into a store for some love. What she want, what she want, what could she want this time? Take all my words, no, she ain't even mine. Believe me, what she do at night? I don't know, but baby, I can guess it ain't right. Cause she got me waiting, contemplating, waiting to break my voice, negotiating it. A conversation, what a shoe-winning argument. I shouldn't even start it, I'm broken hearted. I can't be parted, y'all, I need a taste. So I count my loss.
Thank you.
of the wind ever remembered. The names that was blown in your past.
Let's take that verse from the top.
Count us in.
Excited for this one because my mom's here and she's never heard me read a poem live ever. And for those of you who go here, you know I do the poetry slam, so I just think it's really funny that she's never heard me do one. So this one I wrote last year for the middle school slam, and it actually has a lot to do about my mom. She's the one who inspired me to write it, and her nice friend over there, Joe Ashton.
Woo!
Yeah. All right. So I'm really excited for this one. So this is called Six Tips for the Man Who's Fallen in Love with My Mother. All right. Number one, memorize the color in her eyes. Know every swirl of umber, each fleck of gray, and everything in between. If you see her eyes and you don't recognize the universe, I'm gonna have to ask you to keep looking. They've witnessed around 18,250 sunsets, 650 full moons, and 100 solar eclipses. They have been witness to all four of her children's births and both of her grandchildren's. They say eyes are windows to the soul, but my mother's are telescopes to a vast galaxy of humility, beauty, and perseverance. Fail to realize this and you will never enter our little solar system. Number two, if you've got time, you better make sure it's available for her. Too many nights has she sat lonely, grasped so tightly with the uncertainty if she is as significant in your life as you are hers. No more of this weekend boyfriend only see you when I need a golfing partner business. Buy yourself an agenda if need be. I've heard they help middle school students. Maybe they'll help the middle-aged man trying to win my mother's affection. I've heard you can get them real cheap at the dollar store. Number three, your deplorable habits do not need to become hers as well. Never have I seen her drink to the point of intoxication until she met you. The cigarette butts that seem to spring up around the house like yellow dandelions in springtime are weeds just the same, choking out everything pure around them. Please, help her to be her very best and help her to appreciate what this planet has given us, a healthy working body and clean air to fill our lungs with. Number four, if she's your one, she better be your only. Out of the 10 billion galaxies in our observable universe, there are 100 billion stars that each of them has to call their own, making for around 1 billion trillion stars. Contrary to popular belief, that's an actual number. Let's see. In the entirety of your observable universe, if she is not your brightest star shining, then please keep looking. Because I promise you, to her, you are the sun. You keep her going every single day with the light you provide her. You have brought her day when all she could see was the night. If I find that you have extinguished her light when all she has ever done is nurture yours, then I will slap you with that 50-cent agenda book so hard that you will not be able to hurt her anymore. Number five, hold her hand like it's the end of the world and she is the only one still breathing. Hold her hand like you are a dying man and she is the light that you so desperately want to follow. Hold her hand in every busy parking lot, in every grocery store and shopping mall, and every moment you two have alone. Do not loosen your grip for a second. If you'd like to keep her around, then please prove it to her. Number six, remember, her children will walk 1,000 miles, will carry her burdens and love her all the same, whether or not you are in the picture. She is our observable universe, and everything in our own separate galaxies has been gifted and made possible for us by her. Since the moment we took our first breaths to the moment I am standing up here, it has all been made possible by her. She has lifted us up when we've fallen and carried us when we could not see any direction but down. Even when we felt as though we cannot carry on, she is always the final breath and the final tear on our faces, reminding us that she has brought us into this world for a purpose. She has given us our sunsets, our full moons, and hell, she's even bought us a couple of agenda books. I ask that you do nothing but love her with everything you possess inside of you, and I promise you will not regret a thing. I think the most beautiful thing is the way you've grown so hopelessly attached to this town. It's as though you've carved your name into every tired tree, waved hello to every careless security camera. Without you, this town is breathless. Your cigarette butts whisper life into these aged sidewalk cracks. This night sky knows your tear-stained face better than any uninspired high school teacher you've always dreamt of escaping. You've always spoke of leaving this fragile forest. You've been waiting for this bathwater to drain, watching Tiny whirlpools come and go as this negative energy is only recycled. It will always return to you, no matter how many times you scrub it off in the shower. I've heard people say that you're a product of your environment, but I see so much more. You are the salty ocean breeze in this seaside town. You have limitless potential. But I see that house fire from behind your glass eyes, and though the fire alarm's been sounding for years, I don't think anyone will be able to douse these flames. Because since the sixth grade, I've watched you take care of some that should have been providing for you, because since the day I first spoke to you, I've wished for the ability to tear flesh from bone. I've wished every day that I'd somehow be able to tear a history of alcoholism and drug addiction from your burdened genetics. I've wished for some way, any way to give you the world that you deserve. You cling to this town like I cling to this absent-minded pencil, because without it, you'd be nothing. Please stop telling yourself that you'd be nothing, because you are the flickering streetlights that have kept our favorite back roads lit. Because I look at you, and I see every full moon that illuminates this night sky. Without you, this place is sightless, trapped in the darkness of its own ignorance. Please stop telling yourself that you are nothing. Without you, this town is nothing. I remember you saying that because of me. Cigarette smoke will always be your favorite thing to wake up to, but because of you, I will always be able to fall asleep knowing there's still something good in this tattered world. Because without you, this world is lifeless. Because every time I hear that goddamn song, every time I see a pencil or a guitar pick, I think of how you've inspired me more than anyone to live through my art, live through this art, because you've made this town your canvas. You've got a paintbrush soul and a watercolor heart.
Mother's eyes. With a song on your lips and smoke on your breath, you empty your pockets into your palms, flip, then toss each penny into cloudy water and wish for predictability. You swore you'd stay till the lilies on the kitchen table decayed, and when they did, you became a pair of lost souls wandering among shuddering neon signs, fingers curled around the tattered map that you keep in your left front pocket, the one with tiny red stars scattered between borders, creating a constellation with every place you'd give your life to see. But you'd settle for a photo if it could capture the dizzy rush of midnight blending in with thousands of streetlights, but a photo could never be enough. You longed to hear the can of spray paint clatter when you signed your name on concrete steps, but you'd wait to make sure it'd be washed away. You don't believe in permanence, or you'd spend whole nights wrist open on a bloodstained rug wondering if God could seep in through your veins. Thank you.
Sitting in a bar, in a town. very good friend of mine. He's one of the best freestyle rappers I've ever seen. What this dude does, he takes words that you have all written down. I'm gonna throw some at him, and he's gonna freestyle off of them. I want you to welcome Josiah Gonzalez, everybody. And another round of applause for the Rockin' Redhawks on the beat, everybody.
Yeah, let's go. All right. I'm getting excited.
Whenever you guys
don't start yet. Don't start. Everything this man has said is a lie. All right. You got my words? All right.
Yeah, that's the boss. I didn't swear, man, I did a little pause, yo. Yeah, hey.
and then to prom, but that's a different day now. Imagination, yo, sad to try for quest, biggie, boxing, Alec, next best day, star, not smile, save the star, post, don't forget you can't make it rain without it.
This ride will come to an end, but we can just get in line again. That's it.
If you don't get it, you can ask questions later.
dry you with me, and I'll shower you with laughter, no more pain. Even if we cry our tears or rain, you can just smile and leave it be. No more lonely nights follow.
Just freedom on my chest, hoping that it'll be louder than my words could ever be.
You force me back to a war zone. While your protesters chant, save Syria, let's pray.
But you only care if Jesus is the one who's listening.
It might not be happening here, but we're stranded on dirt roads that become masquerades with nameless bodies and shapeless faces.
I wanted to be a teacher, not a soldier. I didn't want to kill anyone. Please just shoot us or help us. Uni told me to draw a picture of our house because she said it won't stand much longer. I asked her why, but when the tears started, I didn't ask any more questions. Baba reaches for the biggest knife and shouts that he sees no meaning in this life. I don't know what that means, but he sounded hurt.
My name is Ahia. It was 5 a.m. and I clung to my bed sheets as a last line of defense, but they were torn from me. Just like this world has been torn from God.
We've all been torn from each other.
My brother clings to my chest, tells me he's scared, and I have to pretend I'm not. We're blindfolded and bound. I tell him we'll be home soon, back to safety, but
people tell me it won't be there. My name is Hassan, and when I first heard the rocket that killed my uncle and my cousin who always stood by my side, I didn't realize it was targeting the funeral we were all attending.
We live in a place where it's no longer ironic to be killed at a funeral, but expected.
The house of God can't be a home when it's piled high with the lifeless bodies of everyone I once loved.
We can't live like this anymore. My name is Muhammad. I cannot sleep when the screams of 50 women tear my sanity from me like a calf from his mother. I think part of their soul left each time they open their mouths to beg for mercy. I pound my knuckles on these concrete walls until they bleed. I want to tear them down. I need to save her.
We all need to be saved. My name is Aria. I'm Syrian, so you're supposed to be afraid of me, but I have been lost in the rubble and I miss myself more than ever. Rainfall becomes the buckets of water they poured down my back, and every touch is the metal rod scarring my skin. I heard America was beautiful, but I don't think I'll make it there.
5-year-old Laurent Dacniche sits in a brightly colored orange seat, covered in the dust of a broken city, wearing bruises like a warrior's paint. He wipes streams of blood from his tattered face, unsurprised and unfazed.
Why has teaching our children numbers become counting explosions and gunfire? Why has this become normalized?
This is not normal.
This is not all that life has to offer him.
Just days after being rescued from Aleppo,
this empty hourglass, this town of unmarked graves and staggering ghosts, Amran's older brother Ali has been martyred while in the hospital, suffering injuries from another aerial strike, the same type of attack that reduced their home to dust and memories, carried away in a tornado of shrapnel and misunderstanding. He was only 10. Amran and Ali's story is not unique.
Thousands of children are orphaned, their parents bullet covered and never coming back.
Thousands more are injured and lose their lives every day. Why has American peace of mind become more important and their lives.
Just let me know.
Yeah.
Because I knew you. for the things I've done you blame me for. But then I guess we know there's blame to share. And none of this seems to matter anymore.
Nothing but destruction in my dreams, I see it. The work, a titanic construction of brass. Its gaping maw swallows all, crushing and grinding the rock away. The heart, it is one of fire and one of brass. It has shown me such vile things, things such as its home, surrounded by a river of boiling blood and a throne atop a mountain of skulls. In my dreams, it speaks to me. It says such wonderful things. It instructs me. It tells me. It tells me to gather a following. As I do as it says, I build its machines. It instructs me to start a cult. It tells me to gather men and women. Help us build its machines. We tell us to gather more materials, more steel, more, just more. We demand forges, more forges. We do as we say. We mix the molten metals. We build its molten heart. As we finish the machine, we ask for more and more blood, sacrifices of men, women, anyone who is willing. The time has come. The heart burns on its own, but we have one last request of ourselves. We want our souls all. We want them to start the brass, and we want them to kindle the furnaces. Today, we have done it. Today, we have become the worm.
That's the way I like it, and I'll never get bored.
having a tuning moment here.
It's about 3,000 years old, and its theme, it's in Greek, so it means kind of like live in the moment, you know, it's like YOLO except like 3,000 years before that was ever popular. Yeah, I decided to do this during intermission, so just forgive me. It's old, so you can't expect much out of it. Yeah, I just thought I'd share. That's it.
Not like we will, 'cause we got skill. Every time I'm in the zone,
nation. This generation's an inspiration. I don't know why Turner's Falls be hating. Just cause they losing don't mean we're faking. Banners on the wall, look, now we're famous. Everybody knows our name in Franklin. Everybody fears our game in Franklin. Even Massachusetts knows us all. Everybody knows we all play ball. Hitting home runs out of the park. Playing all day till the sky gets dark. Yeah, practicing so we get better. Every afternoon, no matter the weather. And our coaches push us even later. So hard my parents had to sign a waiver.
Are we done?
Yeah, that's
what I said.
That was it, I guess.
I can't drop this. Can't you? No, yeah, you can't. Get up here for a little group photo for the yearbook.
Thank you all for coming out.
I appreciate it. We all appreciate it. Thank you to all the people that are coming up here. You guys all been great. You've been amazing. And you guys are great, you're amazing, everything is just amazing. So thank you for coming.